Dear students, we are going to study about stereoisomerism in coordination compounds. Stereoisomerism in coordination compound is of two types. One is geometrical isomerism, another one is optical isomerism. Geometrical isomerism can also be called as cis-trans isomerism. Now, first of all, we'll discuss in detail about geometrical isomerism, particularly in this video. So some facts you need to know about geometrical isomerism, like first is complexes with CN2 and 3 do not show geometrical isomerism. In case of coordination number 4 complexes, tetrahedral complexes do not show geometrical isomerism, but it is very common in square planar complexes. And in case of coordination number 6 octahedral complexes, geometrical isomerism is very common. Now we need to understand these three points properly first of all to proceed further. Coordination number 2 means, CN2 means central metal atom or ion is bonded with two ligands. So for any compound to have geometrical isomerism, the condition you all know very well, you have studied this in the organic compounds as well. So similar conditions are to be followed here. So with the central metal atom, at least two groups should be there on one side. And on the other side, at least two different configurations should be possible. In CN2, since the particular structure is linear, so this cannot show geometrical isomerism. Same thing happens with CN3. Structure, geometry comes trigonal planar. So when geometry comes trigonal planar, here also we can't have two cis and trans forms. Now in case of CN4 complexes, we can have two geometries. One is tetrahedral, other one is a square planar. When we talk about tetrahedral, then the geometry can be drawn as central metal atom bonded with the four ligands. So you can see here, four ligands are there. All right. Now, the bond angle in case of tetrahedral, you know very well, it is 109 degree, 28 minutes. All right, everywhere the same bond angle. So now suppose if we try to get cis and trans forms in tetrahedral complex, for that we need to exchange the position of two ligands. So suppose we flip the position of any two ligands, situation remains same because everywhere bond angle is similar. Now coming on to the square planar complex where central metal atom is bonded with four ligands and pointing towards square plane. So this is the situation in case of a square planar complexes. Now here, suppose this particular ligand is A. This is also A, this is B, and this is B. Now suppose in this case, if we flip the position of these two ligands, exchange them, then here comes B and here comes A. At that time, we can have two different cis and trans isomers. So that's the reason square planar complexes, they commonly show geometrical isomerism. Now coming on to the octahedral complexes can be drawn as central metal atom bonded with four ligands in a square plane, fifth ligand above and fifth below the plane. This is the situation. Now since in the octahedral compound complexes, we have position of the ligand on a plane as well as axial. So here easily we can have cis and trans isomers. Now let us proceed further and we'll study geometrical isomerism in CN4 complexes and CN6 complexes in detail. So I'm starting with the CN4 complexes. CN4 complexes, two facts are there, you are supposed to understand that. First fact is MA4, MA3B, MAB3 type complexes are unable to exist in cis and trans forms. And second fact is MA2B2, MA2BC, MABCD type complexes show geometrical isomerism. To understand all these things, first you need to know what is the meaning of A, B, C and D. Dear students, A, B, C and D are used to represent monodentate ligands. Monodentate ligands. Remember, wherever I'll speak about MA4 means M is bonded with four similar monodentate ligands. When I say MA3B, remember that M is bonded with three similar monodentate and one different monodentate and so on. So first statement we are going to elaborate, MA4, MA3B, MAB3 type complexes are unable to exist in cis and transform. To understand that, I have made their geometries here. A4 complex comes like that, square planar complex. They are square planar complex, not tetrahedral complex. All these formulas are for square planar complexes. So on changing any position, on flipping any two ligands, there is no difference in the geometry. So this complex cannot show geometrical isomerism. When it comes to MA3B, so if you flip the position of these two ligands, which are different, situation remains same. Suppose A comes here and B comes here, situation remains same as it was earlier. Same thing is in case of MAB3, just like A3B. So that's the reason on changing the positions of the ligand, no two different geometries are possible. That's the reason all three particular type of complexes do not show geometrical isomerism. Now, next we have MA2B2, MA2BC, MABCD type complexes. They show geometrical isomerism very easily, which I have drawn here. They are different patterns and forms. First is MA2B2. MA2B2, see here, M is bonded with 2A ligands and 2B ligands here and here. 2A ligands and 2B ligands. Now, what is the difference in these two forms? Here you can see similar ligands are on same side. Alright, so this is cis form and here similar ligands are on the opposite sides or they are diagonally placed. So this is trans form. So here cis and trans isomers are possible. Now moving on to the next, MA2BC, A2BC. Now here both A, ligand A, are on same side. So this is cis form and here both A are diagonally to each other. So this becomes transform. Now, third case. To understand the third case, first of all, I want to teach you the trick. Trick for all of them, all three plus these two, that how to find out number of geometrical isomers. And then I will talk about the cis and trans in complex MABCD. So in order to understand the trick, what I'll do, I'll note down these formulas. Once again, I'll speak about these formula. Now, what we are going to do, these ligands, we are going to separate in pairs. Means MA4. For MA4, for kind of complexes, 4A ligands are there. So, we can have one pair of ligand AA and other pair of ligand AA, A4. All right. Now, MA3B, for MA3B, we can have pairs like AA, 3A ligands are there, so 2 are here, and third AB, A3B. Now, MAB3, I'll make pair AB, since 3B ligands are there, so BB. So, these pairs are there. Now, these pairs correspond to one geometrical form. Now, let's see whether on exchanging the ligands, can we have a second geometrical pattern? So, if we exchange ligands, we do not get a different geometrical pattern here. So, no geometrical isomers or no geometrical isomerism. Now, here, in case of MA3B, if you exchange the ligands in order to get a different geometry, again, situation remains same because AB, AA, same situation. So, here also, no geometrical isomerism. In this case also, same situation. If you exchange the positions of the ligands or if you interchange them, then also there will be no geometrical isomerism. All right. Now, if we come on to these geometries, MA2B2. So, MA2B2, if I'll make pairs, I'll get AA, BB, the first kind of geometry of these two ligands. AABB means 2A are on same side and 2B are on same side. So suppose this is cis for me. Alright. Now, on exchanging ligands, exchanging ligands, I'll get a different pair. One will be AB and other one also will be AB. So here too, a new geometry is possible, which corresponds to the trans arrangement. All right. Now this kind of situation we did not see in these particular formulae. No different kind of pairing of ligands was possible. Now coming on to the next formula, MA2BC. Now here if I pair up, so first pair will be of AA, second pair will be of BC, suppose. Now if I exchange the ligands, I'll get AC one pair and other pair will be AB. Now here I get a different geometry. Means this compound can show, this kind of complexes can show geometrical isomerism. Now here AA on same side, so this becomes cis, and here A coming on the different positions, so this becomes trans, as you can see here in these structures as well. Now coming on to ABCD, the last one, MABCD. Now ABCD, if I make them in pairs, the first pair will be AB, second will be CD. Two pairs I have made. Now let us flip the positions of the ligands. On flipping the positions of the ligands, I will get one pair as AC, other pair as BB. Now I can flip in one more way. I can have AD and BC. Alright, now let us see all three arrangements here. ABCD, AB on same side, CD on the other side. Second case, ACBD, so AC on same side and BD here. ADBC, ADBC. Alright, now here, these two forms are considered as cis form and this is considered as trans form. Now let us see why and how. Now here with respect to A, if you see position of B and C, they are adjacent to A. In the second structure you see this A and B and C are still its adjacent position, at its adjacent position. Now since cis form is decided with respect to the position of B and the position of B and C with respect to the position of A, if B and C are adjacent to A, B and C are adjacent to A, this particular geometrical isomers are known as cis isomers. In this structure, with respect to A, if we see the position of B and C, so only B is adjacent, C is opposite. So this is considered as transform. So this way geometrical isomerism is shown by CN4 square planar complexes. About CN6 complexes, we'll talk in the next video.